Ever wonder why some designers make over a million per year while others struggle even to find a single new client? I found a few secrets for attracting new clients that separate the pros from the amateurs, which is actually not something that many people are talking about. So in this video, I'll give you all the secrets to getting as many high-paying web design clients as you can by the end of this video. But first, here's how most people try to find new clients. They turn to platforms like Upwork, Fiverr, Freelancer or whatever. This most often leads to a race to the bottom in terms of pricing, and it's almost impossible to attract high-paying clients this way. Okay, so where do you actually start and find new clients? What I've noticed is that there are basically three different levels at which you can do this. Starting from complete beginner to eventually becoming a highly successful web design pro. So let's start our journey at level 1. The easiest way to find clients when you're just starting out is to leverage your existing network. But here's the twist. I'm not just talking about asking your friends or family if they need a website. I'm talking about strategically showcasing them in a way that makes new clients actually come to you. Key strategy number 1. Reach out to your network with a specific free offer. Craft a message that highlights the one particular problem you know businesses in your network are currently facing. For example, your post could read something like this. I've noticed that many small businesses struggle to convert visitors into customers because of website design issues. I'm offering a quick, free of charge audit this week to help identify these issues. With this approach, you position yourself as a helpful expert instead of someone who is desperately looking for work. 4 years back, when I was just starting out as a designer, I literally worked for free just to gain a little bit of experience and build up my portfolio of work. After that, everything became much simpler because I already had this one successful project under my belt and I could use also the testimonials for future sales calls. Key strategy number 2, offer value before asking for anything. And we will come back to this later. By providing immediate value, not only do you demonstrate your expertise, but you also build goodwill. This will make your network far more likely to reach out to you for services in the future. This concept is actually called the value ladder, which I learned from the book .com Secrets, highly recommend, and we will be talking more about this concept later in the video. Right now you just need to understand that if you give people something for free, they will usually come back looking for more value, and that's how you land your first couple of clients. But to really transition to level 2, it's not just about finding your first client. It's also about building consistent income for yourself. You don't want to work free forever, right? So here's how you can strategically approach this. Step 1, build a runway. Calculate how much you need for a 6-month runway. Back then I know I needed to have 10k in my bank to survive for 6 months, so I worked to save up this amount as quickly as possible so I could transition to the next level. Step number 2, match your day job income. Side hustle should make as much as your 9-to-5, but not just in a single month, you should aim to make this amount consistently. Step number 3, jump to full-time. Now this is a big and scary moment. If your side hustle is making the same amount or more than your actual day job, then you're ready to go all in and quit your day job. Bonus tip, this is actually optional, slash your expenses. If you can, spend less on your overhead, because less financial strain means you can focus more on your business growth. Small side note, it took me 1 to 2 years to actually go from this level 1 to level 2. So don't worry if you're struggling in the beginning. It's completely normal and you got this. Congratulations, after you got your first client wins and built some runway, it's actually time to go to level 2. Build your irresistible offer. This next strategy has helped me immensely to raise my rates and sell my services a lot easier. It's really that powerful. You see, the problem that most designers make is that they offer the same commodity that everyone else does. So the first thing in level 2 is you need to create an offer that is irresistible. Let's imagine this for a minute. You have a dog and you're looking for someone who can watch him once a week. You have 2 options to choose from. Person A will watch your dog and wants to give you a good deal. It will only cost you $20 per hour. Person B, on the other hand, will not only watch your dog, but also go outside with him, play with him, feed the dog, free grooming and nail service to make sure he's clean again, and also even take photos of your dog playing outside so you don't even feel like you were gone at all. With all this value, person B costs you only $40 per hour. So which one would you go for, person A or person B? You see, while person B is double the price, it's actually a way more attractive offer since its value is so much higher. So now let's apply this concept to web design. Instead of just creating a website for your clients, think about all the things you can do to 10x the value you give to them. The perceived value of your offer should be 10 times as high as the actual price you will charge them. Let's say your core offer is creating Webflow websites. If you offer this service on your website, it's pretty much a commodity. You will have a lot of other people offering the exact same thing and exact same service. So let's add some value to this. First item that we're gonna add is in-depth market and competitor research. Value added $2,000. Item number two, custom UI UX design with multiple revisions. Value added 3,000 euros. Item number three, SEO optimized content creation. Value added $2,500. Item number four, mobile optimization. This is a big one and actually easy to implement. Most web designers do it anyway. Value added $1,500. Item number five, integration with analytics and CRM tools. Value added $1,000. Item number six, training sessions for clients on using Webflow. This is also easy to sell because they will be needing to use their website. Value added $1,000. Item number seven, free website hosting for the first year. Value added $500. This is also a no-brain offer which you can easily sell. And last item number eight, but I could go on and on, post-launch support and maintenance for 6 months. Value added $2,000. Now your offer not only seems a lot more attractive, it's also not easily compared to all the other web designers out there offering the same basic service. And all that just because you provide them with great value. You can directly use your new offer not just on your website, but also in your pitches and client meetings and show the immense value that you provide. What I love about this concept is that by adding more products and services to your core offer, you can actually make it irresistible by seeming less expensive than what your competitors are offering. But you still charge more. Once you have your irresistible offer in place, selling your services should be way easier and you should be able to raise your prices already. There are basically four ways of finding new clients. The first one is cold outreach, basically sending cold emails and cold calling. Second one is warm outreach, reaching out to people you already know, sending them a DM, email, or calling them. The third way is through content. This is maybe the most powerful way. Social media posts, videos, and your web presence after all. The fourth one is paid ads on Google, LinkedIn, Instagram. We'll be diving into this more in a future video. For now, focus on a single one until you see some success. Point in level two is not to make a lot of money, but to get more client projects and testimonials. Once you already have that, you can get future clients even easier. Because in level 3, we're not chasing clients anymore, we actually want them to come to us. So level 3 is all about building a sales machine that works while you sleep. When you're trying to sell your services online, the mistake I see a lot of people making is sending people just to a generic website showing your portfolio and listing out a bunch of your services that you are offering. Look, a portfolio is perfect if you're trying to land a job, but if you're actually trying to build a business and attract clients, this is something completely different. And to really build your sales machine effectively, you can use one of my favorite strategies that I found in .com secrets, their value ladder. So imagine you're at a fun fair and you've got all these different rides to choose from. Some are free and easy, like the carousel, which you hop onto without a second thought. Then there are those big, thrilling roller coasters that you kind of have to work your way up to, both in terms of courage and, well, the ticket price. Building a sales pipeline for your web design business is actually very similar to navigating a fun fair. At first, you start small. You're at the gates and there's a freebie right there, the carousel. It's basically your lead magnet. Maybe it's a free website audit or a PDF on current web design trends. It gives value immediately, it's free, and who doesn't love free stuff? It gets people into the park, or in this case, into your world of web design services. So next up on the value ladder is the bumper cars, your entry-level offer. Once they've enjoyed the free ride and they're thinking, hey, this was actually fun, you nudge them towards the bumper cars. Not too pricey, but a step up. This could be something like a basic website setup or a discovery workshop. It's your chance to show off your skills on a smaller scale, and it's a bit more commitment from them. Next up is the roller coaster, your core offer. Now they're having a good time and they already trust you. You see the big roller coaster in the distance, which is your core offer. This is the custom website design package, the full branding suite, or the project that showcases what you can really do. It's more of an investment from them, but they've already seen what the fun fair has to offer and they're ready for the thrill. And now the last step on our value ladder, the sky shot, which is your upsell or high-end offer. For the ones who have ridden the roller coaster and are still screaming for more, you have the sky shot. It's the highest point in the fun fair and your top tier service. Maybe it's a retainer contract for ongoing work or an all-inclusive package with web design, SEO, social media management, and whatever you can offer. It's for clients who are ready to go all in, and because they've enjoyed everything so far, they're ready to reach the sky together with you. So how to actually make this work? Well, in a perfect world, we would immediately be able to talk new clients into purchasing our best, most expensive service. But that's almost impossible because we haven't provided them any value yet. Just like at the fun fair, not everyone will jump straight to the sky shot, and that's okay. So instead of trying to convince someone to buy the most expensive offering right away, we build a value ladder that will help us to do two things. First, provide value to each customer at the level of service that he can afford. And second, make money and be profitable while identifying ideal clients who can afford our highest priced offer. So to make this super simple for you, here's a step-by-step approach you can use to build your own value ladder. Step 1. Know what your audience loves. Have a 15-minute chat with 3 of your favorite clients about what they struggle with online the most. Now you already know what a lot of potential clients are needing from you. Step 2. Build your irresistible freebie. Create a valuable checklist or a short video on 5 quick fixes to make your website instantly better. This will bring people into the door. Step 3. Your friendly hello offer. Offer a website tune-up for a price that's a no-brainer. Think of it as helping a friend out. Quick, affordable, and super valuable. The wow moment. Roll out the red carpet for a full website redesign or a brand new site. Make the decision a piece of cake for them. Step number 5. Create your high-tier offer. Introduce your VIP service like ongoing support, complete SEO optimization, or a total branding makeover to those who want to go all in. After each project, ask yourself, what's the one thing I could do better? It's a simple question that I sometimes forget to ask myself, but can really supercharge your business growth. And there you have it. By following these steps, you create a seamless journey for your clients, making each offer feel like the next natural step. And with those strategies in place, navigating from level 1 to level 3, you're not just finding clients, you're building relationships, trust, and ultimately a sales machine around your work. So if you found value in this video, consider subscribing for more content like this. Your support helps me create more videos that can help you grow your business and achieve your goals. Also, if you like this video, you'll love this custom playlist I've made for you that has my most popular videos about how to become a Webflow expert that apparently many people found valuable. Until next time, stay hungry and keep creating.